Hi, welcome back to the Arcade Repair Test video series. Today we're going to talk about using a degaussing coil, or how to degauss a monitor. We talked about this some on our last podcast, and I just wanted to give you a real life example here. This is a degaussing coil. It's kind of a ring shaped, hard plastic, and you just plug it into any wall socket. It's going to be pretty neat. In a minute we'll show you what it does. But I'll talk about it first. All it really does is produces a magnetic field. I'm sure Johnson will write a little bit about that in our article. But it's a real simple tool, and they cost around, I would say anywhere from $30 to maybe up to $100. But a simple one, this one's not very big. I noticed a lot of them are real big. You don't really, for arcade games, the simple one will do. But after you see this trick, you'll probably want to go around and do your TVs and everything. But anyway, this is a degaussing coil, and you say, well, why would I use that? Anytime that you move a monitor, let's say in a game in particular, so you're moving it around, we won't go into a lot of details, but you studied in school about the poles and how everything, all the electrons will try to move into certain, into the corners. So some of you have wrote in, you'll say that your colors look kind of washed out. I really noticed this a lot on like Ms. Pac-Man games or Pac-Man. You can always tell because the ghosts are kind of pinkish blue or something. Anyway, especially in the corners, you'll see this. And it's not a cap kit problem. It's what it is the electrons have moved. And what we want to do with this is we want to spread them back out. So real simply, there's a button on most of these. And if you do a search online, you can find out how to make a homemade one, which I've done before. But it's really neat to have one of your own. What you want to do is start right in the middle and very close to the screen, and you'll push this button. Now, don't let this fool you. Watch the psychedelic colors when I first turn it on. It definitely changes everything, if you guys can see that good. No, we're not tripping. We're not in the 60s anymore. This is what a degaussing coil does. We're going to start in the middle, and we're going to make very small circles. Okay? And then as we come out, we're going to make bigger circles and bigger circles and bigger circles. And as we're moving away from it, and as I was always trained, you basically just do this until you have no more effect on it. As you can see, it's not doing anything to it. As if I go close, it's going to make the screen wobble and do funny stuff. So again, we're going to start small, right in the center. I have a tendency to do this kind of fast. You know, take your time, spread all those electrons out, and as you get away from it, your circle gets bigger until it no longer has an effect, or, you know, generally you're just a few feet away from it. And that's it. And what that will do, that will draw a lot of those colors and make them look really bright and pretty. I wish we had one to show you, but we keep a degaussing coil in our toolbox all the time. And you go moving games around, especially like in this game room where there's rebar on the floor, they'll get kind of washed look. That's the best way to describe it, maybe a washed look. And anyway, very good, very handy tool to have. Can really make your monitors look bright and crisp. A lot of newer style monitors will have a degauss button. You can get the same effect by pushing that button. So if your monitor, say, is 10 years or newer, a lot of times we're talking about classic games, we're talking about 30-year-old monitors, you probably have that. Or sometimes you can go into your options on your game. If you see the word degauss, D-E-G-A-U-S-S, hope I'm spelling that right. Anyway, you can take that, push that button, or go into that setting, and you'll get the same effect. So you might not even need a wand. But very good tool to have. Anyway, as always, thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please, you guys know how to get in touch with us through our website, email. You can call our phone number. But anyway, we want to just thank you for watching. Again, the Arcade Repair Tips video series, now in high def.